read and translate it.
You devil, by doing this, do you think that you will be considered as the godfather of common people? No. You will be despised, denounced by your men. The people for whom you think you are doing this great sacrifice will curse you. Do you know in what way you will be remembered in history? Ye devil, who ruthlessly killed his own son by dropping the chisel from the top at the neck of his son? Out of professional jealousy.
Oh, Chakravani! Chakravani, don't do this! Please don't do this! Please don't kill my son! Please don't kill my son! Oh, Chakravani, don't do this! Oh.
Take it away! That is
alive! I won't allow you to live on this earth anymore! I won't allow you to live on this earth anymore!
This is what actually happened in the life of the great carpenter in 1540. Do you still believe that the carpenter, the great, is mean, jealous, and cruel?
No. Carpenter the Great is not a man of professional jealousy.
Yes, a great man like him can't be jealous.
Killing his own son, impossible.
Great injustice done to him.
So, whatever you hear or read, and you shouldn't simply swallow it. You should try to be critical. You should read it in between the lines. Go and pray for the great carpenter who has ruthlessly been mistaken for centuries.
Observer of time, historian, don't forget to mention me, this poor son of Carpenter the Great.
പഞ്ചായത്ത് പ്രസിഡന്റ് ഒ ടി ജി, ഹോണറബിൾ കറസ്പോണ്ടന്റ് ഓഫ് വിവേകാനന്ദ പഠന കേന്ദ്ര ശ്രീ കെ ആർ ഭാസ്കർ പിള്ളി സർ, റെസ്പെക്ടഡ് സ്റ്റാൻഡിംഗ് കമ്മിറ്റി ചെയർമാൻ ഓഫ് എടക്കര പഞ്ചായത്ത് ശ്രീ കബീർ പനോടി, റെസ്പെക്ടഡ് പ്രീജിയർ പ്രസിഡന്റ് ശ്രീ അശോക് ശ്രാമിക്കൽ, റെസ്പെക്ടഡ് കരുളായി എക്സ് പഞ്ചായത്ത് പ്രസിഡന്റ് ശ്രീ സിദ്ദി, റെസ്പെക്ടഡ് കരുളായി പഞ്ചായത്ത് സെക്രട്ടറി സ്റ്റാൻഡിംഗ് കമ്മിറ്റി ചെയർമാൻ അബ്ദുൾ റഹ്മാൻ, റെസ്പെക്ടഡ് സയൻസ് സ്കോളർ ഓ ഗംഗാധൻ സർ, ആൻഡ് റെസ്പെക്ടഡ് എടക്കര പഞ്ചായത്ത് ഓവർസിയർ മിസ്റ്റർ ദീപു, റെസ്പെക്ടഡ് പ്രിൻസിപ്പൽ ഓഫ് ഹയർ സെക്കൻഡറി സ്കൂൾ രാധാകൃഷ്ണൻ സർ, റെസ്പെക്ടഡ് പ്രിൻസിപ്പൽ ഓഫ് ബി എച്ച് എസ് സി ശ്രീമതി മിനി ടീച്ചർ, റെസ്പെക്ടഡ് എച്ച് എം ശ്രീമതി കെ ആർ പ്രേമ, റെസ്പെക്ടഡ് സ്റ്റാഫ് സെക്രട്ടറി ശ്രീമതി രമ ശിവരാമൻ, റെസ്പെക്ടഡ് ടീച്ചേഴ്സ്, റെസ്പെക്ടഡ് പേരൻസ് ആൻഡ് മൈ ബിലോ സ്റ്റുഡൻസ്, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് മൈ പ്രിവിലേജ് ടു ഹാവ് ഇൻ ആസ്ക് യു പ്രൊപ്പോസ് വാട്ടർ ടാങ്ക് ഓൺ ദിസ് ഒക്കേഷൻ. I am on behalf of Sri Vivekananda High Secondary School and Andrew Fajanji here together, and my own behalf, and extend a very hearty vote of thanks to all for gracing this important preview function and sharing with us your opinions and findings today. First and foremost, it is our obligation to extend our sincere gratitude to Mr. Tulasidan Vithalaya, the English teacher of CFB Vocational High Secondary School, Mayur, Palakkad, and his crew, and like that much of their hard work and effort to bring out such a short film as a study material for the benefit of the student community. Thank you very much, sir. Your team make this day very fruitful, informative and beneficial one for us. We wish you to bring out such visualized materials in the near future. We also wish to express our gratitude to the management, Sri Bhaskaran Pillai sir, Chairman Subhadi Kutiyamma, and Principal Radhakrishnan sir, Primary teacher, new teacher, for providing encouragement and opportunity for organizing this preview show. We must also acknowledge the tremendous support from all the parents. Our heartfelt thanks to the teachers and non-teaching staffs. We are fortunate enough to be backed by a team of very motivated and dedicated teachers and non-teaching staff who support to make this function successful and for whom. Mr. Chairman and ladies and gentlemen, once again I want to state that we are almost grateful to all of you on this stage and all audience who have gathered here to watch the preview show. We thank you for being with us in this fine morning. It has been a great pleasure. Thank you very much.
അവസാനം ഒരു ഒരു അടിപൊളി സിനിമയിൽ കാണുമ്പോൾ തന്നെ നല്ല
രണ്ടായിരുന്നു.
അദ്ദേഹത്തിന്റെ അഭിനയം വളരെ മനോഹരമായിരുന്നു. എന്നാൽ ക്യാമറമാന്റെ കഴിവ് വളരെയധികം എടുത്തു പറയേണ്ട ആവശ്യം. ഈ കഥയിൽ എനിക്ക് ആകെ പ്രശ്നമുള്ളത് പെരുന്തച്ഛന്റെ ഭാഗത്ത് കുറച്ച് ടൈമിംഗ് മിസ്സായിട്ടുണ്ട്. അത് വളരെയധികം കാണുന്ന പ്രേക്ഷകർക്ക് ഒരു വളരെയധികം
ചുമ്മാ അങ്ങോട്ടും ഇങ്ങോട്ടും സംസാരിച്ചിരിക്കാൻ
This is a very old story.
You enjoyed it, yes I know.
Yes, yes.
Our aim is that making you, giving you the confidence. So if you are watching that film, you may go on reading that film too. Then even now people are hiding their crimes. Then think about 500 years ago, a poor man, a carpenter, he killed his son and he burnt all the valuable documents. How was it possible? So we should be critical. Whatever you hear, whatever you read, you should not simply read and follow it. You should analyze and you should read in between the lines what must be the intention behind this thing. Okay, that is the message I want to give. Seeing your face, I think, I hope many of you will become great people. When you become great men, you should have in the corner of your memory this message. You should be critical. You should try to read in between the lines. Thank you, guys. Okay, go on.
Carpenter the Great as a study material to an
the English language interactive skills by an English teacher named Mr. Tulasidharan Vethilayagathu, and his group from Sabri School Parapa. It raised a lot of expectations about the film, as the name reminded me of a Malayalam movie, Perundasan, that I watched a few years back. As for the movie, though the carpenter was a great man professionally, he is depicted as a cruel man, killing his own son out of professional jealousy, based on legends of Perundasan.
The Master Carpenter, as seen in Edihemala, the compilation of legends and folklore of Kerala, written by Kottarathil Shanguni.
So obviously, it kind of curiosity about the film, what this teacher was going to speak and depict about the carpenter differently, that too in a short duration of time, as a study material. But after watching the movie, I got really impressed by the story and the work by the teacher and his team for being a good one with a lot of thoughtful information. The Master Carpenter has been depicted on a positive side, commanding respect from the viewers. My opinion about the character so far had got diminished after watching this film. Film expresses that the carpenter was a great man who respected all people, irrespective of their caste. With its perspectives and a different ending, the story elicits a strong sense of comprehensive study and a quest for analysis, taking me to those old days. My opinion about the characters so far. The truth is that we human beings have spent most of our history killing and degrading of those whom we call inferior, brutal, insensitive. In concert life, we human beings have lived the sixth sense, a special one as we proclaim. The movie also voices on the injustice and ill treatment done by the upper class or the lower class.
Frustrated with incidents, and teaches us that we should not treat anyone as lower.
As the woman who converted into Christianity says that their religion says love is God and they love all around them. What an incredible experience indeed. Convention in this film. Does it mean any convention that had really happened here earlier is alluded?
At Udayanperu near Vaikam, a Christian convention took place towards the end of 16th century. It was said to be the first convention of Christians in Kerala.
Sir, can you say something about your character?
I was actually a typical landlord who is ready to do anything for personal benefit from the Chakravani and the king.
Sir, it was you who handled the role of Sanyasi. Will you please say a few words about your character?
In this film also, he gives a message and advises the people not to swallow all they hear and read, but they should go through in between the lines. However, I am very happy to be the part of this film taken for the students. That's it.
Sir, how did you get this idea of making short films as study material to improve the English language skills, and what is the main force behind this?
Among the four arts, that is listening, speaking, reading and writing. Listening and speaking can do wonders in students. That was why I decided to take these type of visualized dramas to improve the spoken language of our students, especially in English. After exhibiting this film to the students, we will make students to do as many works, as many activities based on the film. And thereby, we improve the spoken language of our students in English. That is the force behind it. This is actually the third film that we have shaped. And in the two films, we did the same thing, and it had actually good results. Majority of the students who could perform well after watching this film, and we could make them do a lot of activities based on this film, they improved a lot. Many students, they were going on watching again and again this film. The very dialogues are written at the bottom of the frame. So, when they watch more than two or three times, actually they won't have any difficulty to understand the film. And any activities, if they are asked to do, they won't find any difficulty. So this was the driving force. We are not going to stop with this third film. Every year we have planned to come out with a short film and donating this thing for the students' community. That is the driving force behind this. Yes.
Sir, your performance is superb in this film. Do you have any previous experiences?
In fact, my relation with the drama goes back to 1960. Then I was a student in the Kudukalur aided UP school. My teachers, I still remember them with reverence. Govindankutty Nair Master, Raghavan Nair Master. They were the two persons who kindled in me the technique of acting in drama. The drama was written by Ayyaneth, the great Ayyaneth. And the name was, name of the book was Chavitti Kulachamanna. My role was of a innocent and naughty boy of 10. And in fact, I got the first prize for that drama. And then there was a period of vacuum. I had to wait many years, to say some 10 more years, to get another chance to enact in a drama for a public performance. Yes, then I was a student in the Government Sanskrit College, Pattambi, studying for my pre-degree class. Studying in the pre-degree class. Then, after my degree, I got chances off and on. And I could act in no less than 10 or 12 amateur dramas, which were all in connection with the annual days of our reading room, the library of our village. Actually, I could not say no to Mr. Tulasidharan sir when he invited me to enact in this short film. My hopes were blooming actually. Even though I am not so much experienced in enacting in front of camera, without any hesitation, I accepted his invitation. And I am very thankful to him. He is such a dedicated teacher, such a good actor. And moreover, his vision as a director and also a writer is something seldom seen nowadays in the teaching field. Anyway, students, you have got a message in this drama, in this short film. Don't cut down, don't dump, you know, swallow everything that you hear, everything that you read. You know, have a vision to, have an insight to go deeper into the thing, and also to read in between the lines. I am borrowing his own words. Read between the lines. That is how you should progress in your path of learning. And you know, if you hear everything and believe everything, as the going says, it is better to be tough. This was my first experience, and I'm very thankful to all the crew members who have given me a chance, and also I wish you all a very fine future.
Abhirami, you did well. Is it your first experience?
No, this is not the first film. This is the third film.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you.